Hello, I'm Tony Stratton, and as some of you may know, I've been the High Sheriff in the Shrewsbury year 2014-15. As well as all the normal Shrewsbury duties, I wanted to engage the business community. That was my theme for the year, and we set about doing that through a business collaboration project, which we call the High Sheriff Challenge. The High Sheriff Challenge, simply put, required businesses who were involved to make a contribution, £7,500, in return for which they were invited to get involved in three events, two receptions, and they had an invitation to the High Sheriff Garden Party. This film really summarises the fun that we had during those three events, and I hope that you enjoy it. The first event, back in July, was the High Sheriff Sporting Challenge, which we held at the Iffley Road Ground in Oxford, that famous iconic ground where Sir Roger Bannister, broke the 4-minute mile. Business sent a team of five people. They competed in 10 events during the course of the afternoon, and then in the evening we transitioned over to the sports hall at Brooks University for dinner. It was a great day, and people enjoyed it. There weren't too many injuries. So that was Sports Day. The second event was in September at Blenheim Palace. We had each business sending four people for the afternoon, and the amazing maestro John Lubbock spent 3 hours turning them into the High Sheriff Choir. That was great fun. That evening we had 200 people for dinner in the Orangery at Blenheim, and the choir performed. And as you'll see and hear, they did fantastically well. Everybody really enjoyed Blenheim, and as you saw and heard, it was a really professional event given only 3 hours worth of practice. After Blenheim, in December, we went to the Said Business School in Oxford, who kindly let us have their Nelson Mandela Lecture Theatre for the evening, and we managed to persuade legendary businessman Alan Layton to come and speak to us on the subject of leadership. Alan has chaired or been non-executive director at a number of companies. He's currently chairman of the Co-op, has been chairman of the Post Office. Everybody learned a lot from what Alan had to say, and I've known him for a long time and was very pleased that he was able to spare us the time.
Get good people, then everything takes care of itself. Get good people, you get great products. So it's all driven by people. And the thing is, everybody's got this now, it's people, 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 but they don't really know what they're talking about. Because somebody told them it was all about people, rather than understanding actually it is all about people. And this thing about businesses don't die, people kill them. Now, people is fundamental to all this, because if you get really good, satisfied, like our loyal and committed colleagues, and my thing is colleagues, I hate it when people use the word staff. I have a thing about staff. You know, we're in the 20th century and we're modern businesses. We're not Downton Abbey. And if you talk to people, nobody has the right to call anybody staff. Nobody has that right. And it's the same thing. You work with people. You don't work for people, and people don't work for you. You work with them. That's what colleagues are about. That's what teams are about. About working with each other. They're not working, I work for.
Those were the three events, and what fun they were. I certainly enjoyed them, and I really hope that everybody who took part did too. We had two receptions during the course of the year. We launched, thanks to the generosity of the MPs of Oxfordshire, at the Palace of Westminster, where we had a small reception, and a few of the MPs showed us round the chambers, which was fascinating. And then we went to Kidlington, courtesy of the Chief Constable of Thames Valley Police, who gave us a fascinating insight into the world of policing today. A number of other spin-offs resulted from the High Sheriff Challenge, probably the highlight of which was the High Sheriff SAE Scholarship. And the SAE Institute, the world's largest network of creative media colleges. And they kindly donated a 2-year scholarship for a student who had the talent, but perhaps not the resources to be able to go to university. We reached out to all the schools in Oxfordshire, We ended up with a shortlist of four, which we interviewed at SAE with Steve Hartley from the SAE Institute and Catherine Ryan from the Matthew Arnold School. And I'm delighted to say that Deglin was our preferred candidate, and he'll start at the college in the autumn of 2015. So that was an unexpected benefit. I really now want to say a big thank you, because the High Sheriff Challenge was delivered with the help and support of a host of people. I want to say a big thank you to the firms that took part in the High Sheriff Challenge. There were over 20 in the end, and their commitment to the project frankly took my breath away. It's meant that we've raised a lot of money, and with matched funding we've exceeded the financial goals that we set for the challenge, and the three charities that we're supporting, Access Sport, Oxford, Music for Autism and the Oxfordshire Community Foundation, will benefit significantly as a result of their involvement. A number of supporters, you'll see a list of them shortly. We couldn't have managed without the generosity of the venues and the individuals who helped make the events work. Ella Pickard, who supported me right the way through my year, and particularly with the High Sheriff Challenge, also deserves a word of thanks. But it's mainly the High Sheriff Challenges, those businesses that were prepared to put some money into the pot and trusted me to deliver the events that I said we would. I'm delighted to think that we have, because I think we achieved our operational objectives, and that money will help us achieve our societal, our social objectives too. So thank you everybody for your involvement, and I'm sure that we'll think of something else to do together in the future. Bye for now.